So we have discussed the average velocity and average speed. Okay. Now, can we try to write the average velocity, can you try to write in terms of position vector? See, it is like this. Right now, the object is at this location, let us say. The position vector is r1, alright? And then the object goes there. The position vector becomes r2. Can I write the average velocity in terms of r1 and r2? That is what I am asking you. This is the displacement. What is this? This is the displacement or not? How much? R1 plus this vector should be equal to r2. Triangle law. So this will be what? r2 minus r1. Okay? So basically we have learned that change in the position vector is the displacement vector. Please write down. Delta R is the displacement vector. Okay? We are going to use it little later. Now suppose I want to write the average velocity. What it should be equal to? Displacement is delta R divided by delta T. Yes or no? Delta R by delta T is your average velocity. Okay. Now suppose I want to find out velocity at a particular moment. Then what should I do? I should decrease the delta T to a very small value. Yes, right? Yes or no? So average velocity for limit delta T tends to 0 will become instantaneous velocity. Delta R by delta T. This is what? Dr by dt. You know this or not? So rate of change of position vector is your velocity vector. Okay. Any doubt? Fine. Rate of change of position vector is the velocity vector. If you differentiate the position vector, you will get the velocity vector. Okay. Now let's talk about time. Time is another motion variable, a very important motion variable. Yes or no? So time is represented by which symbol? T. A small t is used to represent time. Okay. What can I say about time? Can it be negative?
No.
It can't be negative? When I say t equal to 0, what does it mean? Beginning of universe?
The beginning of your frame.
Frame of reference.
From where you started measuring
it? Suppose I have started I have a stopwatch. I have started measuring some activity. So that is my t equal to 0. So before I started my stopwatch, the universe existed. So what is the time before t equal to 0? Negative or not? Time was negative. Before t equal to 0, it was negative. Okay? So time can be negative depending on where you are placing your 0. If you are saying that this is my t equal to 0. So when I was writing this, it was t equal to some minus 5 minutes. Okay? But time always moves forward. Yes or no? So how can you represent that mathematically? T can be negative, but change in time cannot be negative.
T is an element of R where T.
What I am saying is delta T will be always greater than 0. a change in the time. It cannot be negative. Okay? Time can be negative, but it will move forward. Okay? And whatever is the time right now for me is the time for you also. Okay? So, but Einstein have proposed an idea of time axis also. Like for example, your x and y coordinates are different compared to my x and y coordinate. Similarly, if your velocities are different, relative velocities there, your time coordinates will be different. Okay? But that happens at extremely high speed, but right now, all of us share the same time coordinate. Okay? So in this entire chapter, we are keeping time as something which is fixed. If there is an event happening, let's say two elephants are running. So if both of them stop together, both of them take the same amount of time. Okay? So we are assuming time to be something, whatever the time for one elephant is the time for the other one as well. Okay? Alright, so delta t will be always greater than 0. It cannot be even equal to 0 also. Delta t cannot be equal to 0 as well. It can't stop. Time can't stop also. Alright? So you will grow or you will die. As in including myself. Very motivating. Something untrue was said. Focus here. Okay. Now let's try to do some graphical analysis of whatever we have done till now. Okay, graphical analysis. Now, graphical analysis is an analysis done using graphs. And when I say graph, there will be x, y, and z coordinates. Getting it? And usually we just take two coordinates. And we are used to having x coordinate and y coordinate. Alright? Yes or no? We are used to having x and y coordinate. But in this chapter, time can also be a coordinate. Suppose you are plotting a graph in x and y coordinate, you will get the path of a particle. Suppose this is the plot. Okay? This is the path of the particle. Getting it? But if you get a plot like this, suppose this is x coordinate and this is time, and you get a straight line, what does it mean?
X coordinate is not changing.
What does it mean? Physically, what is happening here?
It's not moving.
The object is not moving.
Sir, but it can move in the y direction.
It is moving in a straight line, I am saying. So we are studying motion in a straight line right now. This is just x coordinate. Okay, suppose the only motion that can happen is through the x coordinate. Right now the information is that the object is fixed. Whatever time you take, it has the same x coordinate. Yes or no? This is not the path. Alright? So you need to be conscious about the fact that this is the time axis. These are not your spatial coordinates. Alright? So, can you tell me what is happening here? Let's say this is your x and this is your time. Tell me what is happening now.
Time is going back. It cannot happen.
Why it cannot happen? So this link is not possible at all. Okay? Just because you have two coordinates, you can't randomly draw anything that comes in your mind. Okay? There is a constraint for the time. We have just learned. Delta t cannot be negative. Final time has to be more than the initial time. The change has to be positive. Okay? So this is not a valid graph. Okay? So similarly, like this, have you done graphic analysis in class 9th? Not done. Okay, tell me what is happening here. This is your x coordinate and this is your time coordinate. Tell me what is happening.
It's traveling at constant velocity or speed?
Constant velocity. Does it have constant speed as well?
Yes.
It is motion in one dimension, and the direction of velocity is not changing. Okay, so it is constantly moving in the same direction. So velocity is equal to the speed. And is it constant?
Yes.
How do you know it is a constant?
Because the gradient is constant and it's linear.
But what you have learned? What is the velocity? Well, what is the average velocity? Average velocity between two points is what? The velocity is constant. How do you find the average velocity? You said that gradient is constant, that is why constant velocity. Yes or no? Now, did I say that gradient is your velocity? You are assuming it, right? What we have learned till now is the average velocity is total displacement by total time. That is all we have learned, right? So if the average velocity between any two points is same, then only I'll say that it is a constant velocity. Okay? It is you who are saying that constant gradient, so constant velocity. You are assuming. So don't do such kind of things. Although that is a correct explanation, but the thing is that gradient is equal to the average speed. That is what you have to say. And then say, since gradient represents the average velocity, and hence it is constant because it has constant gradient. Alright? Just because it has constant gradient doesn't mean it is constant velocity. I can plot x versus y and draw a straight line. That is also constant gradient. But you can't say that it is moving in straight, moving at a constant velocity. Because in xy plot, the gradient doesn't represent the velocity. Okay? Now here, can you prove that the gradient represents the average velocity? Suppose you take any two points. I know I am talking about some of the very, very simple things that you have learned in class 9, but then you have to make the basics strong, then only you will be able to solve the difficult ones. So if I straight away give you a difficult question, you will not be able to solve it. Okay, so I am going by the basics of the basics. So please find out the average velocity between A and B. Can you graphically find out what it is? Can you graphically represent where it is? Can you show me where it is? Plot the average velocity. How does it look like? Show. Done. Find out the average velocity between A and B. You have to show it.
I'll finish.
So is it delta H by delta T?
Between A and B, suppose you have to find out what is the displacement. How will you find out?
Y2 minus y.
See, thing is, I am trying to use the average velocity formula, which is displacement by time it takes for that displacement. So where is the displacement between A and B?
X. Difference
is
x
square.
Difference.
If I draw a line like this, okay, this line, is this the difference or is this the displacement?
Yes. Yes.
That is my displacement? Yes or no? Okay? So, this I can say is delta x, which is change in the x coordinate. Okay? Let's say this is x1 and that is x2. Delta x is x2 minus x1. Okay? So, displacement is my x2 minus x1 delta x. And time taken is what? Where is time taken?
T2 minus
x1. You have to see this coordinate. Time coordinate. X axis is your time coordinate. So sorry, the horizontal axis here is your time coordinate. So suppose this is t1 time and this is t2 time. So time it takes to go from here to there is t2 minus t1. Getting it? So graphically, where it is? Graphically, this length or that length is your delta t. Okay, so this is your delta t. Okay, so delta x by delta t is your average velocity. Now delta t by delta x by delta t, which is also equal to this, which is again delta x, and this is also delta t. This divided by this is what?
Tan theta.
If this is theta, tan of theta is that? Yes or no? Now, if I take any point A and B on this straight line, any point, will it come out to be tan theta only?
Yes.
Right? So that is why a straight line in XT graph represents a constant velocity. Because theta is constant if it is a straight line. Okay? If it is a horizontal line like this, then it represents an object at rest. Okay? Understood? Any doubt? Huh.
How is delta x displaced? AB should be displaced.
No, that is what I was saying. This is not a path. This is not path of an object. This is just a plot between x and t. Okay, so this is a very common mistake students do. They assume the plot to be the path of the particle. Okay, because we are used to having x and y coordinates. But if time coordinate comes in, whatever plot you get, it is not the path. Understood? Okay, now tell me what is the difference between these two plots. Tell me what is happening here. Like this. This is object A and this is object B. X and T graph. Can you think over it and let me know? No, you have to come down first. Think over it. Every time, okay, he will be like first one to answer wrong. Think for a minute and then answer. What is happening here? A is beating B. A is hitting B. Kuch bhi. Explain the entire scenario. Entire thing. What is happening? A has initial velocity. Even B has initial velocity. Yes or no? X is your displacement. See, this is motion in a straight line. This is motion in a straight line. Can you explain what is happening? Don't just tell me A is beating B.
Sir,
okay?
A and B started at the same time but at different distance.
Who is ahead?
Different position.
Who is ahead?
A is ahead.
A is ahead. Okay.
And then they move at
different speed. Same speed?
No.
Constant speed. Whose speed is more?
B.
So after some time, B overtakes
A.
This is what I wanted to hear. Okay? You can see at t equal to 0, A is ahead of B. Okay? But A is moving slowly, B is moving faster. So after some time, B has overtaken A. Okay, if you want to see what is actually happening, like, you know, situation wise, you can draw a line like this. B is over, this is your A and this is your B. So A is, let us say, moving with 2 meter per second and B can be moving with 5 meter per second. Okay, and after some time, B has overtaken A, let's say over here. Okay, so using graph you can find out exactly at what time B has overtaken A. How you find out? Just draw like this. This is the time B has taken to overtake the A. Getting it? And what is that location? You draw like this, you'll get the location where B has overtaken A. Okay?